Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to Parkview Health's Facebook Live event. It's National Nutrition Month, and we are coming to you every Friday, the month of March, to bring you healthy recipes, healthy tips, and tricks along the way. We've teamed up with Parkview's registered dietitians, and today I'm joined by Allie Hall, and we're going to talk about squash. And this is a subject I don't know a whole lot about. I don't prepare it a whole lot. I know it's very healthy, and I know it's very easy, so I'm excited about this one today. So I'll let you take it away and kind of explain what we're going to be doing today.
Sure. Okay. So we're going to be making spaghetti squash. This is a great alternative for pastas if you want to use it as a pasta. You could also do just as a side dish. It's a great way to get more vegetables into your diet and try something new. So to start, we just go ahead. These can be really difficult to cut, so be careful. We've pre-cut this one almost all the way. So to finish, just go ahead and get it cut through. There we go.
And I can even help you get some of the sides out.
Perfect. So this is what the inside will look like. We want to go ahead and get rid of all of that and just keep the other stuff in there.
It's kind of scooping out the guts. It's almost like a pumpkin
it
inside
is.
Here.
Yeah, the seeds even look similar. So.
Yes, they do. Again, full disclosure, this is my first time preparing spaghetti squash, so I'm really curious to see how this is all going to turn out.
Yeah.
What are some of the health benefits of squash or spaghetti squash
in
general?
Spaghetti squash is definitely going to be a lower carb, lower calorie alternative to a regular spaghetti. There's also a lot of vitamins and minerals in here, some good source of fiber as well.
Okay.
And it's really versatile too. There's so many different ways you can prepare it. So just get rid of all of that in there. Okay.
Okay. That's easy.
Yes, definitely easy.
All right.
Okay. So once you are at this point, you can go ahead and brush it with a little bit of olive oil. Which we can go ahead and do.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Perfect. So just brush them on there.
And if you're watching at home and have any questions, definitely feel free to write in and ask. Now's your chance to pick the brain of a registered dietitian nutritionist here at Parkview.
So that's just enough to cover it.
Okay.
And then we'll go ahead and put some salt and pepper on here.
Nice.
Get it seasoned.
I'll start on this one over here.
Okay, perfect.
What are some other types of squash that you can prepare?
Well, there's lots of different types. Some other common ones are acorn squash or butternut squash. While those won't come out looking this way, they are definitely other good alternatives. Same kind of vitamins and minerals in there.
But this might be a silly question, but this is the only squash really where you can create kind of that spaghetti.
Yes, the spaghetti noodle look.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
All right. So where should people preheat their oven?
Typically, you want to go about 375 to 400.
Okay.
And depending on the size of the squash, it can take anywhere from, 35 minutes to even an hour. We are at 400 today, so we'll go ahead and
Right. Yes, I will be right back.
Okay. I'll
take this over here. We did have a question come in on Facebook.
Okay.
Jennifer wants to know, is spaghetti squash available year-round?
It is. Yeah,
okay.
I believe so. I've purchased it. It's always available at the store. But like I said, there are different sizes. These ones happen to be pretty large, but I've seen them a lot smaller, too.
Okay. So we've magically cooked.
Yes, we have.
Yes, so this is finished. This, again, was in an oven, 400 degrees for about an hour.
Mm-hmm.
So, and it's fully cooked. So
yes.
I've never done this before,
okay.
So you definitely have to show
me. So basically what we'll do now is just take a fork. Is all you really need.
Okay.
Take one here. And you just start to scrape it out. And see, it starts to take the look of noodles. So you can just start pulling at the sides here.
This one broke, is that normal?
Yes, it can happen, and
okay.
It will still taste wonderful, but it's just sometimes when you cut it, it tends to crack a little bit, so that's kind of where that comes from. Just go ahead and start scraping.
Look at that.
I know. So there's the noodles.
That's It smells amazing.
They're delicious. It's a really mild flavor, so it's really versatile. You can use any kind of sauce, and we'll show some different varieties.
Yeah.
So.
All right.
And like you can see, I've only done a little bit, and there's already a lot.
So you scrape this all the way down the sides.
Yeah, it will be almost just the outside little rind left.
Okay.
By the time it's all done.
Mm-hmm. And the prep literally took 5 minutes.
That's all it takes.
If that.
5 minutes. Super easy.
Very easy.
Mm-hmm.
So I will just put the, it is still a little warm, so I guess that's a good caution is to be careful bringing it out of the oven.
Yeah, that looks perfect.
Okay. And I will get this out of your way. Alright, so you were talking about a couple options that you could do as far as toppings on this. We've got some pesto today. Mm-hmm. I think I'm going to do a little Parmesan cheese.
Who doesn't love parm?
Yeah, and that'll kind of melt on there.
Yes.
And drizzle a little olive oil.
Mm-hmm. Looks great.
Gotta have some garlic, right?
Definitely.
That looks wonderful. That does look good. Mm-hmm. All right, what are you gonna do for
I'm gonna go the traditional route, and we're just gonna use a spaghetti sauce to top. Another good thing to add to this would be, you know, maybe some meatballs if you wanna do that, get a little protein in there. So,
I wonder if you could even trick your kids to thinking that this is actually spaghetti.
It really has a really mild taste. It's got a little bit of a different texture than a regular spaghetti noodle, but other than that, it's a really good alternative.
Okay, good. I'm going to take a couple more questions that have come in on Facebook Live. Sarah wants to know, how do you know they are ripe? I find it hard to cut them, so I wonder if they're not ripe.
I think that's just kind of the nature of the spaghetti squash. They are definitely difficult to cut. So just be careful when you do it. That's why sometimes I choose a smaller squash when I do make it, just because it's easier to cut that way.
Okay, and that's a great question, Sarah. I had that same thought today as we were cutting through a couple of these, but they're ripe and they cooked up and became very soft after an hour in the oven. All right, well, it looks like we're going to be wrapping things up here. Thank you, everyone, for joining us. Thank you, Ellie, for joining us today. And definitely something easy to try at home and healthy as well. So happy Nutrition Month, and we'll see you next Friday.
Bye.